So next we elaborate the topic, that is the restoration process when only the noise is to be added. In the previous video, in which we have discussed what are the applicability of the various noise model, we defined some topic which have the equations for when we do not add the degradation function, we have only the noise model. So we have only the noise's presence. So in that case, we get the degraded image gx comma y is equals to fx comma y plus the additive noise eta x comma y. That is the equation in case of only the noise's presence for the degraded image. To enhance that image, when only the noise is to be present, then we use the filters like the mean filter and the order static filters. In the case of mean filter, we have categorized the mean filter into the arithmetic mean filter, geometric mean filter, harmonic filter, contra harmonic mean filter. So in case of order static, we have the median filter, max mean filter, midpoint filter, and the alpha trimmed mean filter. So we will discuss these filters one by one. So let's start with the mean filter. What are the mean filters? So the mean filters are the noise reduction spatial filters that are introduced to develop the several other filters, whose performance is in many cases superior to the filtered. So there are various filters which are to be used further in case of mean filter. The very first is the arithmetic mean filter. Here this is a smooth local variation in an image where the noise is to be reduced as the result of blurring. So we use the function that is gs comma t, which is to be used as a degraded image. Here the coordinates are to use s comma t. So capital S base x comma y is the set of the coordinate in a rectangular sub image window of size m comma n. We have some image of size m into n. So we select some part of that image, or that part of the image is known as the sub-image, or we have the same coordinate that are to be represented by x comma y. So we get the desired image, that is the output image, which is the enhanced version, which is similar to, after applying the degradation function, we get some image, output image, that is the enhanced image, which is similar to the original image, that is represented by a function f cap x comma y is equal to 1 divided by mn, capital mn bhi likh sakte ho yahan par, number of columns into the number of rows, summation s comma t, which is belongs to s x y g s comma t, clear, which causes a certain amount of blurring, which is proportional to the window size of the image, thereby reducing the effects of the noise. So we can be used to reduce the noise of different types, but works best for the Gaussian uniform and enlarged noise. So this is the very first mean filter, which is the arithmetic mean filter, which can be used to reduce the noise in case of the uniform noise model, in case of Gaussian noise model and long noise model, clear. So the second one is the, after the arithmetic mean filter, the next one is the geometric mean filter. It is comparatively, as compared to the arithmetic mean filter, it may achieve the smoothening, losses less image detail in the process. So we can say that it is the more appropriate as compared to the arithmetic mean filter. In this, we use the equation, that is we get the enhanced image that is represented by f cap x comma y is equal to pi s comma t, which is belongs to s x comma y g s comma t whole power 1 divided by m n. We can say that the geometric mean filter is a variation of the arithmetic mean filter. It is primarily used on the images with the Gaussian noise. It retains the image details better than the arithmetic mean, which means that it does not losses the image quality as compared to the other filter, or we can say that it may exist or correlate the image details, does not lose the quality. So these are the two mean filter, arithmetic mean filter and the geometric mean filter. Next we have the mean filter is the harmonic mean filter. In case of harmonic mean filter, we have a equation for the enhanced image. Is we get the enhanced image by the equation that is m into n divided by summation s comma t that belongs to s x comma y into 1 divided by g s comma t. So this is the another variation of the arithmetic mean filter, which is useful for the images with the Gaussian, the salt noise. We have the black pixels, which are the pepper noise, are not filtered. Last one mean filter is the contraharmonic mean filter, which may reduce the effects of the salt pepper noise. We have some of the values like Q is greater than 0, which may estimate the pepper noise, where Q is the order of the filter. Q is less than 0, we estimate the salt noise. Q is equals to 0, which means we get the arithmetic mean filter. If the Q value is minus 1, we get the harmonic mean filter. It cannot eliminate both the salt noise and the pepper noise simultaneously. So for this function, we use the equation like f x comma y is equal to summation s comma t belongs to s x comma x y g par q plus 1 s comma t, or we write this as g s comma t par q plus 1, aise bhi likh sakte hain, and divide by summation q g par q s comma t, aur yahan par ise aise bhi likh sakte hain g s comma t ikattha likhe whole par q. So summation is also s comma t belongs to s x comma y. So this is the contraharmonic mean filter. Further, the contraharmonic mean filter further be classified according to the applications, where the positive order filter is effectively reduce the pepper noise at the expense of blurring the dark area. Negative order filter may effectively reduce the salt noise at the expense of blurring the bright area. Arithmetic and geometric mean filter suit the Gaussian or the noise, uniform noise, particularly the geometric mean filter. Contraharmonic suit for the impulsive noise, yet with the information of the dark or the light noise to select the proper sign for Q. So these are some of the application we can say that where these filters are to be compared with the previously discussed noise model.